So in this video, I will take a look at vectors in the plane and some of the most important ideas and concepts that you should be aware of. First, a vector in the plane in general is written in this form, A1, A2, like this, the two components, or it could also be written in the form of A1i plus A2j, where I and j are the unit vectors on the x and y axis respectively. So I is here and j is here. So vector A can be written either in this form or that form. A vector, of course, is a quantity that has both a magnitude and a direction. The magnitude of a vector is basically its size. Its magnitude is written in this form, magnitude of the vector A. It's basically given by the square root of A1 squared plus A2 squared. So that's the magnitude of a vector A. So if A, for instance, is the vector -1, 2, then its magnitude will just be the square root of -1 squared plus 2 squared. So it's going to be square root of 5. Magnitude of a vector is always either 0 or a positive number. So that's the first thing that one should be aware regarding vectors. The second is that if you have a vector A like this, a certain vector A, we are often interested in finding a vector in the same direction of as A, but with a magnitude of 1. So this is basically what we would call a unit vector in the direction of A. Okay? So you're often, we will be interested in finding a unit vector in the direction of a given vector A. So, for instance, if A is the vector, if A is the vector, let's say 3, -1, then I want to find the unit vector in the direction of A, the unit vector U in the direction of A, then basically what's happening is that I want to find the unit vector U. Well, what we do is basically we find the magnitude of A, and 1 over the magnitude multiplied by the vector A itself. So let me erase some of this thing here, so we don't want that. Multiply by the vector A. So this is the rule for finding the unit vector in the direction of a vector A. So in this particular example, so you have two steps. First, you need to find the magnitude of A. In this particular example, it's going to be the square root of 9 plus 1, so it's square root of 10, and therefore the vector U that we're looking for, the unit vector, will be 1 over square root of 10 multiplied by the vector A, which is 3 minus 1, and therefore basically it's going to be, we can write this as 3 over square root of 10 and minus 1 over square root of 10. So that is the unit vector in the direction of the vector A. We can check that if we find the magnitude of U, well, of course, it will give us exactly 1. Well, occasionally, we're not interested in vectors of magnitude 1, but of a given magnitude. So you could find, you could be asked questions like this to find the vector of magnitude, say, 3 in the direction of the vector, let's say, A, which is minus 1, 2, say. Okay, so I want to find this time a vector of magnitude 3, not 1, not like the unit vector like we did before, but this time I want a vector of magnitude 3 in this direction, in the direction of this vector A. Well, the idea here is to first find the unit vector. So first we're going to find the unit vector. So first find the unit vector U and of course we know how to do that, so it's going to be 1 over the magnitude of A multiplied by A, so it's going to be 1 over the magnitude of this vector A is basically 5, so 1 over 5 multiplied by minus 1, 2, like this. So it's going to give us minus 1 over 5 and 2 over 5. This is the unit vector, so its magnitude is 1. Now if I want the magnitude 3, then I just need to multiply this vector, this unit vector, by 3. So the vector of magnitude 3 will be, or is, okay, let's call it V, say, yeah, it's going to be 3 multiplied by the unit vector U, so it's going to be 3 times minus 1 over 5, 2 over 5, so that means it's going to be minus 3 over 5, 6 over 5, and that is basically the answer to our question. Okay.